the Quran that you have today, in Arabic.
But honestly, you're talking on a topic that I don't know anything
Arabic,
about.
In Arabic, bro. So your Qurans have changed. You need to deal with it. You need to deal with it.
I haven't changed from what I've been reading.
Do you know the Salah manuscript?
No, I don't. Top but are you, you're talking about things I don't know. So there's no point in having this conversation.
Your ancient manuscripts, they've changed, bro. The Quran has changed. I'm just telling them. The Sana manuscript, the top copy manuscript, these are some of the ancient Qurans that you have today, and they have changed. They're not the same as the Quran today. Do you want to debate me on the Quran, sir? Sir, has the Quran changed?
No, it hasn't.
Sana manuscript, Sana manuscript. Doesn't want to debate me, sir, sir, sir. Do you want to debate me on the Sana manuscript?
I'm Muslim, but I'm not here to debate.
Yeah. Sana manuscript, do you know about the Sana manuscript? In the Sana manuscript, there are textual variants, it's not the same as the Quran that you have today. Did you know that?
What is the Yona?
You know you've got ancient Qurans in Arabic. Yeah, you've got ancient Qurans, you've got many ancient Qurans, yeah? Very old Qurans. Now, some of these old Qurans go back very, very, very far back. But when you look at these ancient Qurans, they're not the same as the Quran that you have today. Because there's different words and different sentences. So you need to check it out. It's the evidence. I can read you the evidence if you want it. You want me to show you the evidence? Show you. Show you the evidence here, yeah? So this is... Show you now. Okay. Sir, this is the top copy Musaf manuscript in Turkey. Early 8th century. Right? Dr. Ekmeldin Isnoglu, can't pronounce his name, founder and director of RCCCA. He's a Muslim scholar. The top copy has 2,270 consonant differences to the Quran that you have today. That's from a Muslim scholar. And 22% of the Quran is missing.
What's the evidence?
I've just shown you the evidence. This is your Muslim. This is your Muslim scholar.
That's not evidence.
I'll give you some more evidence.
That's not evidence.
I'll give you more evidence.
That's some information they picked up on the internet. That's not evidence.
His opinion. But then if he's coming from a scholarly background, well, he must have based on something.
What scholarly background? He hasn't got any scholarly
background. It's not
background.
Personal opinion. He must have studied.
That's just something he's picked up on the internet. Anybody can make anything up.
I'm going to give it.
Where's the evidence?
Yeah. Well, do you know who that is?
Where's the evidence?
It's like
where
a historian.
Historian. I'm waiting for the
evidence. I'll show you. We'll go to data.
I'll show you. No evidence.
Let's go to data.
Let me show you.
No evidence so far. Point one, no evidence.
I'll show you.
There's source material.
Who is it?
I know where the top copy is. I've been there.
No, do you know?
I've been to the copy museum.
But do you know who that is?
No evidence so far.
Do you know who that is?
Regardless of who he is.
Who is he?
Regardless of who he is.
Who is he?
It could be anybody.
Who is he?
You could be anybody.
Who is he?
I can take a piece of paper out of my pocket and make wild claims with no evidence, which is what he's doing.
Let me tell you who he is. He's the world authority on the top copy. That's who he is.
That's what he claims.
No, he is.
No evidence so far.
He is.
Just claims. No evidence.
I'll show you.
He's an expert. If someone's an expert, we have to take them on. They're being expert. They're
field. Real expert with no evidence apart from just.
I'm no expert. I mean, he's getting towards an expert. But he's talking about an expert.
You claim he's an expert, and he claims he's an expert, and so far no evidence.
Let's go on to more.
Okay, fair enough.
Let's go on to more. Yeah. Okay. Kaf and Basra, these are in Hadith. Medina, these are in Hadith from Medina.
Show me the Hadith.
I'm showing you here.
No, you're not showing me anything. He's just giving me
facts.
Quotes. No, he's not giving me the text, interestingly enough.
Okay.
No Arabic text so far, and no Hadith in Arabic so far.
Right. Let me show you.
We need to see verses.
Our conversation will be based on baseless allegations with no evidence.
Let me show you.
Show me them. I'm still waiting for the evidence.
Let me show you the verses from this side of the city of Kaffa and Basra, in Hadith, which I'll show you in a minute, it says recommended. Then in Medina, it says it was recommended. That's Surah 132. Right? Hasten to forgiveness from your Lord.
Where's the Medina?
Let me finish. Hurry up to the remission of your Lord, 133. These are in Hadith. Now the Hadith.
Where did you get all this?
This is Dr. This is Dr. Shahid Salim, who is a Muslim scholar.
He's a Muslim scholar.
And here he is. He tabulates.
www.muslimscholar. How difficult is that?
That took so much
painstaking research.
Off the internet, by the way.
Picked by a lay person.
Yeah. Listen,
did you pick up
this guy's
this
a PhD? This is a guy.
PhD. Gina's a Christian guy who left the Christianity, wasn't it?
Now let me ask you a question.
Gina Emman.
How can you say that the Quran has not changed?
He's a PhD holder, man.
Pardon?
Everything's on you to prove it.
No.
The onus is on him to prove that the Quran has been changed. So far, he's done nothing but provide baseless allegations of the internet with
from
no evidence.
From scholars.
Wait a minute. Do you believe that, Edmund? He was a Christian. He's a scholar. And he left the Christian.
Where's the evidence? Give me the evidence.
It's the same thing.
Give me the evidence.
Okay. But he's always been an atheist. He believes in science. That sort of guy. He's not a man of faith.
I've got to go.
There's some people that are too academic. They have atheistic minds. They're not spiritual people like us. Yeah, we believe in God because we're spiritual people.
No. He's
people like that. They're atheists at heart.
No, he's just run off. I'm going to show you.
He's more scholar than you, you know.
I'm going to show you. He's run off. Never mind.
What do you want to show me?
Let me just finish. If you could just come on me, man.
Yeah.
Number one, I showed him a world authority on the top copy. That was the first thing. Secondly, I showed him from Hadith, and if he'd have stayed, I'd have showed him a list of the scholarship at the back of the article. Now he wanted the Arabic. Here's the
Arabic. We don't believe some Hadith is this.
Now, I'm going to give you the Arabic.
Let me finish.
I'm going to give you the Arabic. In the Wash Quran, it says, he will forgive. In the Hafs Quran, in Arabic, and there's the Arabic. It says, he will forgive, we will forgive. It says, in the Wash Quran, Arabic, they do. It says, you do. It says, in the Wash Quran, Arabic, we will pay them. It says, he will pay them. So that's the Wash and the Hafs, they're not the same. So
there's differences.
There's differences in the Arabic. So I've given scholarship, I've given Hadith. Now we're going.
Only the real pronunciation.
He's trying to show you evidence.
No. Only the difference.
So I gave scholarship, then I gave Hadith, and now I've given the Arabic, and we've shown that these Qurans are not the same. So thanks a lot.
Jason,
so if it had stayed, I would have given it him, but it wasn't interested.
Jason, it doesn't help you. I swear. It doesn't help. It doesn't help you.
Are you interested in a debate? Are you interested in a debate?
No, I never debate anybody.
Okay, so...
I never debate. I'm not a scholar.
So what are you doing here? Are you here for a debate or not?
No. What do you mean debate?
Oh, it's just a share of information.
I'm not a scholar.
Yeah, let's open our mind to truth.
Mansour, he knows better than me.
Okay. He will forgive, we will forgive. How are they the same?
Okay, can you read the Arabic?
You read it.
Al-Baqarah.
You read it.
That is chapter 2.
We will forgive.
And he will forgive. That is the two different. When you read, are they the same? No. Yes, of course it is.
Right.
No. One, for example.
We will forgive.
No, listen.
We will forgive.
Do you know
he
why?
Will forgive.
Do you know why? That is the two different, things on the chapter. Have you got a Quran?
I've got a Quran, yeah.
Have you got a Quran? Read. Al-Baqarah. What is he talking about? 58.
In your Arabic,
when I talk, right. I said I will forgive you.
Right.
When the God talking, He said, we will forgive you.
Okay.
I will forgive you.
It depends how it's written.
Yeah.
And if there's changes in the dialect, it has a total different meaning.
Do you know some Arabic before originally?
Right.
Do you know the like Hamza Fatha? Do you know the it doesn't come. Later on, do you know the ulama, the scholars, just how to pronounce, right. You know, that what they did. For example, at the time of Usman, you know, like in Russia.
Right. Is it a different translation based on region?
No, for the region, yeah.
Yeah, regions.
For example, if I read in English,
yeah.
Same like Jason.
Right.
I can't pronounce it, same like him.
But if there's different regional Qurans,
Qurans. What I'm saying is, for example, like I'm going, the American, they said, I want to go, something like that, you know.
I understand.
But the meaning is still the same.
Okay. Let me come back. In two Arabic Qurans, the wash and the halves.
Yeah.
In the wash, it says, he will forgive. That's in Arabic. You agree with that?
So who said?
It's in your Arabic Quran.
Yeah, but who said?
There's the Arabic.
Jason, I hear
what you're saying. Yeah. Just listen to me a minute. Then in another Quran, the halves, another Arabic Quran, we have, we will forgive. So you
but
have...
There is no difference.
He will forgive, we will forgive. Which is it?
It depends, do you know which, do you know who's talking about at that time?
So it's two Qurans?
No, that's not Quran. No, Quran, we have got only one. Go anywhere.
Honestly,
we are not the same like a Christian. Christian, many Bibles.
You can cope with it, don't worry, you'll get over it.
No, we respect your opinion. We're looking at it as like two versions. And what you're saying is regional, for that they're pronouncing differently.
Sometimes, but the meaning.
Yeah, and so Arabic has two meanings.
In the Quran, right?
But depending on how it's interpreted.
How would you say?
But when we're going through this scripture, the meaning of the verses, it depends if it flows.
Like Hatun and Che and Smith.
Yeah.
You know, all the propaganda, man. Don't follow them.
One Quran may be wrong.
You can say yourself
than the other.
But really, they are
do you agree? No. If it's translated wrong, then it's a wrong translation.
The meaning is different.
Yeah. So in this other Quran, they've translated in this way, and in the other one, instead of we, they put I.
No. For example, in the Quran,
and it should have been we.
For example, in the Quran,
made a mistake.
Same like a Bible. No, it's not a mistake.
Yeah.
Do you know in Arabic, it's the same like English.
Okay, we're talking about we and I. There's like, someone talking about together, we say, or I say.
Is that a plural or single?
This is the thing. That this is his point.
Yeah,
if there's two versions, one's saying it's plural, another one's singular.
Yeah, it's the same thing.
So there's two books there.
Yeah, but it
depends which one's true.
No.
Which one's true? Is the scripture talking about in singular?
Okay.
Sorry, you've got to be careful, mate. Thank you. You've got to put some of that back in the blessing.
Is it off there?